All right, good evening, and I hope our day was good. Today, we'll be talking about how to establish an healthcare facility in Nigeria. I hope you are all hearing me, and I hope I am audible enough. All right, you all can see my screen, right? You all can see my screen, right? Everyone can see my screen, right? Can you all see my screen?
Yes, sir, we can see.
All right.
We can see your screen, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. All right, so we'll just go straight to the point. There is no time to waste. I'll be talking about how to establish an healthcare facility in Nigeria. All right, so like I've always said, you don't need to be a doctor, don't need to be a nurse or an healthcare practitioner before you establish an healthcare facility. If you have the money and you have the passion, you can actually go into this business of establishing an healthcare facility in Nigeria. It's very simple. All you need to do is just to have the knowledge of this business. I have been in the business of practicing privately for more than 3 years, let me not exaggerate, and I can tell you that there have been ups and downs, but the profits and the benefits outweighs the risk and the down. All right, so let's continue. That's my beer, that's my biography. I'm sure you already know that. So how to establish an healthcare facility in Nigeria? When we talk about an healthcare facility, I'm sure you understand what we mean by an healthcare facility. Healthcare facility does not only mean hospital. All right, healthcare facility does not mean hospital. When we talk about healthcare facility, we are talking about the sum total of all medical centers in Nigeria. Okay, now, what are the type of healthcare facility we have in Nigeria? According to the Ministry of Health Law, we have some specific type of healthcare facility in Nigeria. So if you want to go into establishing an healthcare facility, you must pick from this listed healthcare facility I have listed. Number one is private hospital. You can have a private hospital, you can have a private clinic, you can have a private maternity center if you're a midwife, you can have a private nursing home, you can have a private physiotherapy clinic if you are a physiotherapist or you want to go to the business, you have the money to invest. You can have a private dental hospital, that's dentistry, where I take care of the teeth. You can have a private medical laboratory. You can have a private ophthalmic hospital, also known as eye hospital. You can have a private clinic or ophthalmic center. You can have a mortuary services. You can have a mobile clinic such as ambulance. You can have an advanced life support services such as those that take care of emergency, BLS and ACLS. You can also have a private home care services, a private home care services where those that don't want to go to the hospital are treated. All right, you can also have an industrial clinic where the clinic is located inside a company. You can have a private dialysis center where people that have kidney failure, kidney diseases, come and take care of themselves. You can have a private public primary health centers, okay? You can have alternative medical services such as Tradomedica. You can have assisted reproductive therapy, such as IVF center, okay, IVF center and all those places where they normally donate sperm, donate eggs. You know, I'm sure you must have heard of all those adverts on social media. You can have a private diagnostic center, that's also known as laboratory. Okay, you can have a private special diagnostic center. You can have a private radio diagnostic center. You can have a private radiotherapy center. So we'll be looking at all this one after the other. For an hospital which will be starting, this is a proper building you can use. Now, I always tell people, do not, if you are a private health practitioner who is just starting, please do not let your hospital to be situated in a story building. Can you all hear me? I want to assume that you are all hearing what I'm saying.
Yes.
All right. If you are just starting, if you are just starting, please do not rent a story building. That means look at this story building. Look at this story building. Don't let your facility to be upstairs. There are limitations if your facility is upstairs. Look at this story building now. Don't let it to be upstairs. There are limitations. People are discouraged to climb the stairs when the story building is upstairs. They are discouraged to climb the stairs. So always go for downstairs. It's important you go for downstairs. Now we will be looking at, right. Okay. All right, so I have written an article on this healthcare facility. So I'm going to show you. Okay, I'm going to show you. All right, so yeah, I think you can see here. Yeah. All right, so this is one of the articles I'm using, which I'm going to be using today. Okay, now I need to mute. I don't know who just joined. All right, now on this lecture, I'll be teaching you the requirement of what you need. I hope you're with pen and paper, although I will send this right up to you. Don't worry, I will send it to the group. But some of the requirements I will be mentioning are not on this write-up, so you will still need to write out the things to write out depending on what you want. Now, some of the requirements you need in establishing an hospital. Very quickly, some of the requirements you need in establishing an hospital. All right. Now, like I've always said, Nigeria is a large populated country, where we have about 191 million as at 2017, because they have not done census. They have not done census for the past how many years? No, for the past 5 years, they have not done census. So the last census was 2017, and the number has grown more than that. All right, now, the health centers and the government hospitals we have in this country is not enough to cater for this population. That is why private health facility we always sell, we always be invoked. All right. Now, what are the type of healthcare facility in Nigeria as projected by Ministry of Health? Number one is hospitals. Hospital. Write it out. Hospital. We'll be talking about hospital and the requirement. This hospital is very common in towns and cities. It's a big establishment in terms of structure. Very well. You can't see the material. You can't see the material. You can't see it. Can you all see it?
Yes.
You can see it, right?
Yes, I can see it.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right.
Yes,
now, I can see it, sir.
Okay, all right. Thank you. Well, if you cannot see it, if you cannot see it, I will send the material into the group. I can't do that now because I'm already teaching. But if you can't see it, don't stress yourself. Don't panic. The material is available. I will send it to the group. So you don't need to stress yourself. If you miss any point, you can always refer to the material. All right. So, like I said, like I was saying, hospital is a very it's very common in towns and cities. It's a big establishment in terms of structure. It can occupy a single building, or a complex building. The hospital is a place where all manner of treatment are being treated or taken care of. For those that are more than what they can handle, they can always refer to tertiary hospitals, or they can always refer to the general hospital. You know, hospitals have more, look at the difference between hospitals and maternity is that hospitals have more operational activities than nursing home and maternities. Hospitals have more equipment than nursing home and maternity, okay? All right? Hospitals have more things, more duties they can do than nursing home and maternities, all right? But, and also, an hospital has many units, such as pharmacy unit, medical laboratory, okay? Most private hospitals have between 10 to 50 beds, you know? But for maternity home, you are only allowed to have 4 beds. Or for a nursing home, you are only allowed to have 4 beds. All right? So now, what are the requirements in setting up an hospital? If you are following this lecture, I will tell you that it is not the building that make up an hospital. Rather, it is the personnel. What is a building if there is no qualified doctor and there is no qualified nurses to work there? So many of you who are nurses or doctors or who must have seen a place where a woman delivered a baby inside Danfo, but because you are opportunity to be a doctor or a nurse or a medic, you get able to assist that woman to deliver a baby. True or false? The woman do not need a building to deliver. Neither did she need a building to be able to push her baby. All she needs is a qualified personnel. That is why the Ministry of Health did not so much stress on the type of building you can use. They only stress that you must have a building that separates the male from the female. Okay, now we'll talk about it. One of the requirements of setting up an hospital is the business registration. Let's talk about the business registration. You must have a business name in mind. So I want to ask you a question. What is your business name? You want to set up an hospital and you don't have a business name. You must have a business name registered with the Corporate Affairs Commission. That is where we are taking this lecture one by one in a way that you will understand. Your business name must be registered with CAC. Number one. Number two, you must have a practicing license. If you are a registered nurse, you're a registered midwife, you are a registered doctor. If you are not any of these, that means you must have someone who is going to assist you to open an hospital if you have the money. So that means all hospitals are expected to have a practicing license issued to the doctor, which is authorized by Medical and Dental Council of Nigeria and is subject to renewal every year. Professional association. You must understand that every business in Nigeria has association. So the issue of I go still join association again. Which one be that one? Even tomato seller in the market has association. Even bikers has association. Pure water sellers have association. If you think I'm joking, carry a bowl on your head. Go to Osodi and go and hug pure water. If you will not be beaten up. Pure water sellers have association in this country. People that are selling okrika have association in this country. So don't think that you can start any business without joining association. It's not possible. So professional association, if you are a doctor, you have to belong to Association of General Private Medical Practitioners, AGPMP. While if you are a nurse, you must belong to the Association of General Private Nursing Practitioners, AGPNP. So you have to locate these associations in your various states. Authorization. The Federal Ministry of Health, we have to confirm that you have the required qualification that gives you the legal right to operate an hospital in Nigeria. That brings us to this website. I'm going to be taking you to and fro, so you have to follow me. You have to follow me. Now, on this very website, this is the website of the Lagos State Ministry of Health. You can see what I'm doing. This is the website of the Lagos State Ministry of Health. Now, luckily for you, registration of health facility is now done online, unlike you have to go and take the form in their office. Now, look at it. For registration of, if you want to register an healthcare facility now, you have to go and take the form. Do you understand what I'm saying? The first thing you need to do, let's assume you want to register an hospital, you are a doctor, or you want to register a nursing home or a maternity home, you are a nurse or you are a midwife, or you have the money, you are not a nurse, you are not a doctor, you are not a midwife, but you just have the interest of opening an hospital, a maternity or a nursing home. You are not a doctor, you are not a midwife, you are not anything, you are an engineer or you are a farmer. The first thing you need to do is decide, what do you want to do? You want to open a maternity home where pregnant women will be delivering, because maybe in your community, in your village, you discover that there is no maternity home, nowhere pregnant women used to deliver. All of them used to deliver at home. Or maybe you are a nurse and you feel, maybe you are an engineer or you are a farmer and you feel you have a room in your house where you have an apartment in your house, and you feel that you can use it for a nursing home, especially if you have up to 4-bedroom flat. Yes, what you have to do is just to employ a nurse or you employ a midwife for a maternity home, or employ a doctor. Maybe you want to go for an hospital. This is the registration, the form. Now, registration form, whether for an hospital, for a maternity home, the registration form is how much? How much can you see here? How much can you see here? They are not talking. Talk now. How much can you see here?
10,000
naira.
10,000 naira.
Good. So the registration form is 10,000 naira in every state.
Okay.
The registration form you can see here is, you can see I underlined it, is 10,000 naira. So if you go to Ministry of Health, you can see it's written on their website, especially in Lagos State. The registration form.
Yes, sir. I'm saying 10,000 naira.
Good, 10,000 naira. Now, when you pick the form, you can even download the form online. Let me show you how you can download the form online. You can even download the form online so that you will know what and what is on the form. Let's see if you can download the form online. Please, whose phone is ringing? Put your phone on vibration or mute your... Okay, now let's... Please lower your TV set. Let me... I don't understand how people want to learn. You are watching TV at the same time you are on a class. All right, so now... let's assume you want to register an hospital now. You want to register an hospital. This is the Ministry of Health requirement for an hospital. Can you see it? Can you see it? You can see it, right? Oh my God. This is the Ministry of Health requirement for an hospital.
We can see.
All right. If you can see, this is the building. The building. Now, in this place, they are trying to describe the building. Yeah, but let's move away from the building. Let's talk about the equipment. Look at, we'll come back to the building later. Let's talk about, for the building, let me just tell you straight. For the building, for an hospital, you need a minimum of four-bedroom flat. How is it four-bedroom flat? You need one room for a male. You need one room for a female. You need one room for theater. Then you need the other room, you need it for emergency. Then you need the parlor of that flat, you need it for reception. Most times, the kitchen of that, no, most flat has kitchen. So the kitchen can be used as a laboratory or dispensary room. Why? The dining can be used as the consulting room. You will just cut it. That's for a start, for statement. So that's the kind of building that is acceptable, four-bedroom flat, okay? Four-bedroom flat. So that's what this A, that is what this A is trying to describe, all right? Now, let's look at the part B. The part B talk about the requirement. This is the requirement, is on the right top, but I'm just saying, I think both of you, all of you, we like it if I bring it out directly from the Ministry of Health. No, some people are good at asking, what is your source? What is your source? And tell us your source. We cannot be tsunami the forger. So you can see, the first thing you can see here, delivery bed, delivery instrument, oxygen, sonicare, which is fetal Doppler or fetoscope, your weighing scale, baby resuscitating machine, okay, this one is utterly optional because you can utterly refer. Suction machine is compulsory. Your standard light, of course, your theater have to be illuminating, okay? So basic hand washing facilities, that's your tap. There must be a tap outside and there must be a tap at the back of the building. Appropriate medical waste bin. There must be a waste bin at the entrance of the hospital, which is reception. There must be a waste bin at each room. There must be a waste bin in the doctor's office or the nurse's office and the injection room. Suitable theater equipment. You can see the equipment here. Okay. Now, for diagnostic facilities, you don't need this. This one is for lab. This one is for lab. You don't need this one. Okay, so we are at section D now. This section D, you can see that there is suction machine, oxygen cylinder, oxygen concentrator. You can have either of these, not compulsorily, you have the two. Oxygen cylinder, oxygen concentrator, you can have either of this. Autoclave. Hope you know what is oxygen concentrator now. Oxygen concentrator. I hope you know what oxygen concentrator is. Let me show you.
Yes, sir. We know what it is. Yes, sir.
No.
You don't know.
Not seeing this slide though. We are not seeing the slide.
I'm typing. Can you see what I'm doing? Can you see what I'm doing?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm trying to show you an image. There are so many oxygen concentrators. This is an example of oxygen concentrator. Okay. All you just need is electricity. You don't need to feel it. For those of you that are non-medical people, that is why I'm showing this. That's why I'm showing you this image. Okay. So that's an example of oxygen concentrator. Okay. So, all right. So, oxygen concentrator, autoclave. You know what autoclave is? You know what autoclave is? Yes. For an hospital, you need patient monitor. You need patient monitor. You know what's patient monitor now? You know patient monitor?
No.
Okay. You know, okay, patient monitor. Let me search for you. Patient monitor. This is patient monitor. I'm sure you have seen this before. this patient monitor. Can you see? You must have seen it in movies.
They use sir.
They use it in checking patient data signs. It makes your work easier. So this is one of the requirements. Although it's not compulsory. It's not compulsory, but it's good you have it as an hospital. It makes your client care faster, and it makes your client to heal faster. Okay, so if you have the money, you can actually buy that for your hospital. They said any other hospital equipment or instrument that may enhance the services of the facility. That may enhance the services of the facility. All right. So, hand washing facility, such as liquid soap, dryers, tap, what have you? Medical waste. This medical waste, look at this place. Look at where I am. Medical waste, part F. This medical waste. The Ministry of Health, when they come to your facility, the first thing they check is the color code. There's what we call color code. This color code, your medical waste, for the reception, it has to be black. For the theater, it has to be red. Injection room is yellow. Patient ward is brown. Do you understand now? That's what it. And all this nylon, you can buy it in the market. You can buy all this nylon in the market. I can give you a phone number of someone that can supply you. She works in the Ministry of Health. So when you buy your waste, buying your waste bin, your waste basket, or your plastic waste basket, you have to also ensure that all this nylon are well arranged. You don't go and put red nylon inside the waste basket in the reception. It's wrong. You don't put brown nylon in the waste basket in the reception. It's wrong. The reception has to be black nylon, while the theater has to be red nylon. Why? Because when the waste management authority comes, they will know which one blood contains, and they will know which one that contains ordinary waste. So we are running out of time. So please, when we log out, please also use the same code to log in as soon as possible. We have just 10 minutes left. So when we log out, please use the same code to log in as soon as possible. Don't forget that. We have just 10 minutes left. All right. So now, what is the minimum staff requirement? What is the minimum staff requirement? For an hospital, if you are not a doctor, you need a doctor. You need to employ a doctor. An average doctor collects 80,000 naira to 150,000 naira, depending on the location, depending on the bargaining power. You don't expect a doctor who lives in Victoria Island to be taking 80,000 naira from you. It's not possible. You don't expect me to pay a doctor an hospital in Ikorodu to pay a doctor 150,000 naira. You don't expect an hospital located in Ibadan to pay a doctor 150K. Like I said, it depends on the location that determines how much we pay a doctor. The same thing, you also need one registered nurse. Look at the requirement. Part G. Look at this part G. Look at it. Minimum staff requirement. One medical practitioner in charge who serves as the operating officer. If you are not the doctor serves as operating officer. While you, who owns the facility, you will now be the proprietor. You need one registered nurse in charge of nursing services. That is why most private hospitals, they always employ one registered nurse to cut costs. But except the hospital is so big and busy, they can have more than one registered nurse. So that is why when a farmer visits your facility, they don't care how many registered nurses you have. They just want to see a registered nurse on duty. So one registered staff nurse or midwife or staff nurse per 8 inpatient bed. That is, for an hospital, one registered nurse to 8 patients. You can imagine, one registered nurse to 8 patients. One doctor to 8 patients. All right. Then you must have a laboratory center. You must have a laboratory center. Okay. You must have a laboratory center or, sorry, you must have a laboratory technician or a laboratory scientist. This one, you can employ a laboratory technician, all those people that are graduated from School of Health. Also, you can have one registered pharmacist or pharmacy technician also, but all right. Then we also have medical record secretary. All these requirements are for hospitals like Redditing, hospitals like St. Nicholas. If you are just starting, I can tell you that what you need is just a doctor and a registered nurse. The rest will take care of himself. This is what the Ministry of Health wants. You know, Nigeria, this is what the Ministry of Health wants. A medical doctor and a registered nurse. You can tell them that all your samples are being sent out to a nearby laboratory. You can also tell them that for your pharmacy, you are the one that normally dispense the drugs yourself. Okay, so for medical records and for medical records, secretary, kitchen staff, you can employ an assistant to be helping you to do all that. Okay, so, and they expect you to have a generator or inverter. You can see they put inverter here, optional. They expect you that you must be connected to PACN or standby generators or inverter. That's power supply, because you must have source of power supply. Other requirement, part J, other requirement is you must have fire extinguisher. You must have muster point. I hope you know what is muster point, where people normally gathered when there is fire outbreak. You must have a valid fire safety certificate. You must have a valid fire safety certificate. This one is also important. It's important. All right. So now you now know the requirement of an hospital. You now know the requirement of an hospital.
No. I don't know.
All right. So you now know the requirement of an hospital. Let's move on. Let's talk about the maternity. Let's talk about, now we have spoken about hospitals. Is that clear? The hospital, is that clear? Before we move to maternity. Is the hospital clear? Do you have any question? Do you have any question?
No.
Any question about the hospital and the requirement? Before we move on to maternity center, any question about the hospital?
The boys are business, please.
No.
It's clear.
Is it clear?
Clear.
Yes.
Thank you,
sir.
For the hospital.
No, sir. It's clear, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right. To recap, I told you that hospital is not about the building. It's about the personnel. So if you are a registered nurse and you want to set up an hospital, please, you need to get a doctor. Okay, so it's important you get a doctor. So when you have gotten a doctor, every other thing is easier. The doctor is just the only difference between an hospital and a maternity home. Okay, the doctor is just the difference. I got this question all the time. Osage, what is the difference between hospital, maternity, and a nursing home? The thing is that Nigeria is full of naive people. Nigeria is full of naive people. They don't know the difference between hospital, clinic, maternity, and nursing home. No, most people don't know the difference. The difference between an hospital, maternity, and nursing home is that hospital has a doctor, but for a maternity home, it's being run by a midwife. Okay? It's being run by a midwife. For a nursing home, it's being run by a registered nurse by myself. Okay. Oppo is raising her hand. Oppo, go on. Ask your question. Go on. Ask your question.
I've asked Okay. What is the minimum bed spaces for a hospital?
For an hospital, the minimum bed is 4. The minimum bed space is 4. Yes. For an hospital, the minimum bed space is 4. And you can have as large as 100 beds, 50 beds. But the minimum bed you are allowed to have for an hospital is 4. So that is why you are... That is why you have to have 2 rooms. One room for a man, one room for a woman. So that one room, you put 2 beds in ward A. Please lower the volume of your TV set. Lower the volume of your TV set. Thank you. Now, for an hospital, when you have 2 rooms, you put 2 beds in ward A, which is for female, you put 2 beds in ward B, which is for a male. Both of them can be using one bedroom and one toilet. It's accepted. Okay, Oppo, you are raising your hand again. Go on. Go on.
Okay, then what about if there is need for pediatrics? Yes. Can you join them?
Yes, if there is need for, you know, normally I said it is 4 bedroom flat, but if you have 3 bedroom flat, it's also accepted. Lagos is the most strict state in Nigeria that they normally follow the rules. The rules. We are logging out now, so please, when we log out, you quickly log in again.
Okay.